Jake, PTV is lucky enough to come to your hometown of Elliot in the Northern Territory. Here we are, 700 kilometres or so north of Alice Springs and 700 kilometres south of Darwin. It's a fantastic place for us to come. What does it mean for you to be able to come home?
Well, for me to come home, you know, and just see, catch up with friends and family, big proud moment for me for what I've achieved. And you know, I'd just like to thank the Port Adelaide Football Club for taking their time off, you know, and then, like, for coming and seeing my community and also mingle up with the primary school. And yeah, just like, so I said, you know, just seeing the environment that I live in and growing up into.
I assume this football oval here and all the ovals and every spare piece of grass around the place was a place you must have spent a lot of time playing footy as a kid.
Yeah, well, this is one of the first oval I've actually put my foot on, I guess. But yeah, hopefully many to come, I guess. But yeah, well, coming back here, you know, bring back some memories, I guess. But when I was a little rascal, running around here. But yeah, I can't explain. You know, words can't explain how proud I am, how far I've gone in my journey to become a AFL footballer now. So yeah.
Tell me about playing football up here, Jake. First of all, I'd have to say it's pretty hot.
Yeah, very hot. Remember when I first started off, I used to play barefoot, but yeah, after playing a while, soon as I moved back to when I was boarding school in Alice, I started using shoes and footy boots now. So yeah, coming back here and, you know, just having memories, like I said, you know, just of me running around.
And were you always a little bit on the shorter side against some of the other kids in town when you were young playing here?
Probably was the shortest and probably lightest, but you know, I guess everyone have their way of getting a kick, I guess. So yeah, I just tried my best.
So now that you've gone through all that journey through Alice Springs, through Ballarat, through being recruited by Port Adelaide, what do you think when you think back on your time here and now that you're down in Adelaide and, you know, playing AFL games?
Oh, you know, it was definitely worth it. Like, the move to Alice first and the move to Ballarat, I was not too sure what would happen, but all I knew is that I've got to finish my school off first, so that's what I've concentrated on. And then, yeah, no, just footy on the side of it. But yeah, I actually helped playing good footy too as well. And now I'm very proud of being drafted and coming back at home, you know, be a good role model to my people back at home.
We certainly saw that today and yesterday. You obviously are a really significant role model in the lives of these young people, and probably for young Indigenous people all over Australia for that matter now. How does that sit with you? Are you comfortable with that? How important do you see that being?
Yeah, I'm pretty comfortable with it. But I want to be a role model not to only my community, also to other communities around Australia, like remote communities as well. Just showing them, you know, how far you can go if you put your foot on, put the foot down on the accelerator and go for it, you know, like just taking your options, I guess.
You said to some students that talent only gets you so far. It takes more than talent.
Yeah, like I said, you know, I had talent in me, but to be a successful AFL footballer, I had to change my attitude and make sure, you know, I'm always there training and make sure that I'm on top of everything. So yeah, that was a big change for me.
And not all of the kids who you're influencing now are going to be AFL footballers, of course, but you can clearly influence them in other ways. You know, getting an education was clearly important to you, and you think it's important for those kids too?
Yeah, no, definitely. Like I said, you know, I had to finish school first, make sure I'm on top of my schoolwork, and which I did. Now, and then got grafted on top of it.
A highlight must have been to play a game at Traeger Park on Saturday night in the power colours. How was that? The crowd was pretty excited.
Yeah, no, well, it's been 4 years. 4 years since I played in Alice, but nah, it's been like, you know, same like here, I guess, but just playing with an AFL team now, and you know, just getting around other players, and also my family coming down and watching me play, which pretty significant in my life, one of my highlights, you know, watching me run around, play with the pro athletes. Yeah, it's an amazing experience, but yeah, hopefully more to come.
Were you a bit nervous going out?
I was a bit, but then soon as the game started, I was all right then after it. So I just wanted to get it on the way. I was just nervous because the lead up to the game, but soon as the game started, I felt okay.
And what did it mean to you having your family in the stands and then down on the boundary line afterwards, after you managed to have a win?
Yeah, no, I guess with the win, I was pretty happy, you know, to have a win with it. But yeah, my family coming down, you know, to take their time off and actually come down and see, watch me play. I'm pretty generous with that, and hopefully they might come down and watch us play in a premiership one day.
That's fantastic. Let's all hope so, mate. Thank you very much for having us in your home community. It's an absolute honour, mate.
Thanks for that. Thanks for coming.